brought to you by GTA, your island, your network.
And as part of fulfilling his fundamental responsibility in terms of the health and welfare for the people of Guam, Governor Eddie Calvo has signed off on another commutation, but this time working with the federal government.
This individual has a federal detainer. So with that in mind, the federal government now has that responsibility to help subsidize this individual's incarceration at this point in our prison. And then at the same time, the federal government has a responsibility also to process this individual for eventual removal, deportation from the island of Guam.
The governor authorized the transfer of Linus to Cal Alter, an FSM citizen from the state of Calsaray. Alter is a convicted rapist sentenced for 2 years and scheduled to be released next year. Calvo says Alter was identified by U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement as having committed a deportable offense. This marks the eighth inmate no longer in custody at the Department of Corrections through the governor's initiative. The timing couldn't be more fitting as Governor Calvo recently had a teleconference with Robert Riley, the U.S. ambassador to the Federated States of Micronesia.
Now, with Ambassador Riley, he's fairly new in this assignment, so it was more of getting to know you and also asking some of the questions on what are the issues and, of course, working towards a resolution. So I feel very positive about this is that now we're seeing representatives of the federal government trying to get more involved, which has been a problem in the past, to see how we can deal with the issues particularly that are important to Guam, such as the removal of non-citizen convicts from our island home to their home nations.
And just as he believes there's been some major shortcomings, Calvo says the ambassador informed him the feds are willing to work with the U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement in increasing their participation in the deportation process.
At this point, he's more supportive in seeing what we can be done.
And while Ambassador Riley didn't commit to any additional monetary support at this time, Calvo says he believes there's this clear understanding of the issues Guam faces. Calvo says he informed Ambassador Riley over issues regarding a change in policy by the FSM government for citizens that had been incarcerated and were now going back to their home state. In the meantime, the ambassador has since asked Governor Calvo to have a face-to-face meeting. Reporting for Guam's News Network, I'm Ken Quintaniza.
Brought to you by GTA, your island, your network.